Hashtag, it's Audrey Scafati.
And it's Mason Glott, and welcome back to Marvel Mondays.
We quite literally just walked in the door from Eternals. It is 12:45 in the morning, and we are getting our thoughts down right now.
Let's do this. This new Marvel movie tells the story of 10 new heroes sent to Earth to protect humans from deviants. Okay, Audrey, I'm so curious. Overall thoughts?
I don't know. I thought that it was an alright movie. I thought the script could use some work. I thought that it was fun to see new characters, and there was a pretty loaded cast, which I thought was cool. But overall, I think I was just underwhelmed in general. What about you?
I agree. So much happened, and I don't even know what to say. I think it did some things good, they did some things bad, and we'll talk about it, but overall, not as cohesive, not as momentous as I would have wanted it to be. But, you know, that's okay.
All right, Mason, what is one negative thing that you took away from this movie?
I think the story in this movie was just not that good. I think it tried to do way too much. I think there was no real focus. I don't know, just so much happened. It didn't feel like one continuous story. It felt very just not condensed, not well done, unfortunately. I hate to say that, but I just don't think the story was very good in this movie. What about you?
I agree with you. I also think that the script and the dialogue was a huge weakness. I think that Marvel typically does really well with the dialogue and scripts and screenplays, but this one, I just was feeling really underwhelmed and honestly kind of disappointed in just like what the quality of the dialogue was.
I agree. Like, there are some parts that tried to be funny, and some parts were funny, but a lot of it fell flat, I think. And yeah, I don't know. Any dialogue wasn't that great.
I also think that it made the characters very two-dimensional and very hard to really like. There was a few characters that you were like laughing at, but other than that, it was like really hard to connect to them.
This movie was just not fun to watch. The tone was just, I was sad during it. It was not a happy movie. It was not a fun movie. The characters weren't having fun. I wasn't having fun. It just felt very empty and bland. What about you, agree?
I do agree. And something else that I thought could have used some work was just like the building of the characters in general. I thought that our main protagonist, Cersei, I thought that her powers were not as strong as they needed them to be, and yeah, that was another huge flaw with this movie.
Also, quite frankly, I did not care about her at all.
Oh, no.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry I didn't.
Okay, on a lighter note, let's find some positives in this movie.
Yeah, I think this is salvageable for the future. I think we can salvage this. There are definitely good components. I really loved the character Druig, who could control minds. I thought he was really cool. He was written really well. He had some like moral dilemmas I was really into. And he was my favorite character. I liked following him a lot. What about you?
A positive that I have found is just the cast. The people in the cast were stacked. We got Angelina Jolie, Kit Harington, Richard Madden, like so much, like big names. I also think that the cast in general was very diverse. Mm-hmm. And I thought that that was so cool to see, just like so many different people that look so many different ways. There was someone who was using ASL, like that was a big part in the movie. And I really just thought that this movie should be applauded for its very diverse and intricate cast.
I agree. I also think the VFX were pretty good in this movie. It was cool. The action scenes were really cool, and I liked the enemy of the deviants. I thought they were designed coolly, and I don't know, they were actually scary to me. And I think that worked. I wish there was more of that throughout the film, honestly, because I feel like that would have made it more focused and more exciting.
I agree. I feel like the action parts were some of the most enjoyable parts when I was watching. Like Mason said, that it wasn't a fun movie. I had the most fun when they were being superheroes and doing fighting scenes and like just doing action scenes, which is what we were kind of there for.
Yeah.
So I really enjoyed those parts.
A lot of talking in this movie.
A lot of talking and not very good dialogue.
No, I don't care what you have to say. Okay, so overall thoughts, final thoughts.
I thought that this was not the best Marvel movie. It made me leave the theaters feeling disappointed in... I didn't have high expectations, but I didn't have low expectations, because I never have low expectations for Marvel. So it just didn't meet my standard.
Yeah.
And it was like, it was fine, but I don't know if I'll like ever choose to sit down and watch Eternals.
Yeah, no, I agree. This was definitely a huge risk for Marvel, and I applaud them for taking the risk. But this was too big of a risk. They didn't need to do that. It felt like too much. I don't know, I feel like as Marvel gets into Phase 4 and they want to start diversifying their content, they need to understand why people like Marvel content, because so far, What If and now Eternals, both of those, I don't think the risk paid off for either of them. Also, stay for the end credits. Audrey was very excited about that.
Stay for the end credits.
Kind of saved the movie in some ways.
It saved my movie-going experience. Oh. I recommend staying for the end credits.
That's all we have time for this week. I'm hoping for a super positive Marvel Mondays next time. I'm Mason Glad.
And I'm Audrey Scafati. Back to the desk.